Let's take a look at how we can make our Pytest fixtures more dynamic by turning this person's fixture into a factory. We're going to start by adding the keyword arguments to the fixture function. Next, let's add a nested function inside that also passes down the keyword arguments. As a convention, I like to use the same name as the fixture, but with an underscore in front. We'll move our person object to be returned there, but we're going to initialize it with the keyword arguments that we pass down. Let's make the fixture return our nested function. Now we're going to refactor our test, and we're going to have it treat the person fixture as a function. Let's run the test to verify that everything works, and they pass. So what's happening here? When we call our fixture, we're reaching to the nested function inside and passing through the keyword arguments to the person object. In its current state, this isn't too useful, but it shows us the basics of this nested function pattern. Let's extend this a bit further and not have it call every person Bob, but instead generate a unique name each time. We'll add a count variable outside of the nested function. We'll then get access to that variable inside of our nested function by using Python 3's non-local statement, which just tells Python to retrieve the variable from the scope above it. Each time that this runs, we want it to increment the count. And let's attempt to pop the name out of our keyword arguments. But if that's not present, let's default it to Bob with our count tacked on at the end. And we'll pass the name to our person object. Let's add one more test to demonstrate what the fixture is doing now. Each time it runs, it should generate a unique name as the count is incremented. But we also have the ability to specify a name if needs be. Let's run the test to verify that our fixture works as intended, and they pass.